Hello and welcome to FX Bootcamp London. My name is Christian Stevens. Today is Friday, April 16th, 2010. This is your daily London session video. A review of just a little bit of what we did today in the live London session class at fxbootcamp.com. Let me first remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. We are not an alert service. Myself nor any of the other currency coaches will ever provide any direct trade recommendations during the course of any session. Please be mindful that trading under leverage is always risky business, and occasionally as a novice trader using excessive leverage may work for you. Unfortunately, more times than not, this leverage, using excessive leverage, will work against you. So please don't trade real money until you have a proven track record of success on a free broker demonstration account. Simple as that. Before we get started, one more thing. Whether you're watching this video on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, or our blog at FX Street, I'd like to ask if you could please leave any sort of a comment after you're done watching. We appreciate hearing from you guys. Seriously. Well, today was fun. Basically it was kind of goofing around, just playing between support and resistance. Pre-London had some good trades, and in the London we had some good trades. Had a nice little short on the pound dollar down to a very highly overlapping area of support where we had a nice take profit and an opportunity long, and that happened on a couple pairs. The one I'm going to talk about right now is probably the hardest entry it seemed some of the members had in the room taking, which was the euro yen. I'm going to go to that one real quick. Now, first of all, keep in mind that quite a few of us were short this pair and have been short this pair for days. And I'm going to show you the relevance of the area here at 125, basically 125.20 zone, okay, which if I pulled down a daily chart, wasn't really reached yesterday. In fact, what did we get to? Let me see. What was it? I forget what it was now. It was 125.30 zone. So we got pretty close to it, but I want to show you the significance of it and what caused us to build a trade plan long on this. And actually, unless you stayed in, I'll show you once by the time this video is over, unless you stayed in for the whole move, and when I say the whole move, there was some late fundamental news that came out that excelled this trade ultimately to more pips. It wasn't the biggest trade out of the bunch tonight that was available, but it's still worthy to talk about. So this was, looking back here, I'm going to go back before this daily candle because, just to give an idea to back this out a good ways. First of all, this area of 125.20 zone was an area way back last year, a significant zone where we had a level of resistance a couple times and then followed up with support. And more recently, sorry, I'm looking at some other charts at the same time. More recently, in the range that we've been in, there we go. This right here, as you can see, support, resistance, broke through here, no question about it. But the idea that this would be an area that we would find a level of interim support is very valid. Now, I'm not looking for necessarily reversal here. We have a weekly trend line coming way down, kind of pushing us down, and we're really getting pinned here on this euro yen. The idea that this could pull back to around 126 or something before maybe trying to continue further south seemed very sound. In fact, that's what I'm looking at right now is the trades that I'm in right now are continuing. And I'm going to actually have to pause this video. Hang on just a sec. Okay, sorry about that. I'll continue with this video. I had to take a step on a trade that I did there. It's very embarrassing. I'm trying to remember where I left off here. This is a repetitive area of support and resistance on the euro yen. And if I go take this daily off the chart, okay, and I scroll back to during that time. All right. You can see this thick green line here, right here. This is the daily M1 pivot point overlapping with that key area and around 25 that we're looking at. Okay, so this was not a situation that we were necessarily looking to what I would call auto long the pair at euro yen at the level, or even automatically take profit on our shorts that we've been in for days, because there's no reason to believe we can't break this ultimately. But this was, quite frankly, the first target. Okay, and if you look at it on a two-hour perspective, you possibly can even see this area that traders have found as resistance support back and forth over and over again even more clearly. Okay, so if we break this, then maybe we get a nice fall. But realistically, you really wouldn't expect this to go straight through. And in fact, what we talked about in the room was the realistic thing that would probably happen is a pullback back to somewhere close to the 126 area. And when you take that into consideration and go back to this these other charts here, you'll see the hourly where the 21 EMA was at the time was, I believe, at 125.80. And if you look here, you have a weekly central pivot point at 125.70. You have a 4-hour 5 EMA coming down to meet price, which at that time I think was at 125.80 as well. So you had a lot of stuff just before 126. And if I look at a 15-minute chart, not to try to complicate things, I'm trying to lay the groundwork here. Well, I didn't mean to go out that far. This was the previous area of resistance that just before intraday, before we had fallen to this zone. This 125.71 area, recent swing highs, seemed like a pretty reasonable place in order for that to 70 to 80 would be a challenging place to break, especially when you consider that's also the weekly central pivot point. One more thing going back to the daily is if you take a fib of this entire move up all the way to the bottom here, this is also a 382, oops, I didn't mean to go there, I meant to go here. A 382 fib of this entire move here. So, I mean, we had a lot of overlapping reason to look for some kind of a clue for maybe a scalp long. And the last element that you have to add to this is, think about this for a second, okay? You're at support, very visual support on several levels at a major market open, right at the London Open. What do you think London traders are more likely to do at that point? Do you think they're going to be interested in shorting at support? Probably not. At least they're going to wait or long, depending upon which type of trader they are. And you're dealing with some profit-taking things and that sort of nature. But this was not a reversal-type long. This was a long-to-get-short type of a setup. So essentially what we're looking for is any kind of clue to scalp long, at least to 2570, maybe up to the 2600 area, we'll see, and then go short, okay? So here's how it played out. I'm going to pull out a one-minute chart, and now because I paused the video and was in trades, I've actually got to scroll back to this moment here. If you can bear with me for just a moment here. This video probably sounds choppy with me having to pause it like that. Apologize for that. Okay, it's taken pretty much forever. All right, now we're approaching the area here. This is right at London Open. Now, there's an entry just prior to London Open, and there's a later entry as well, okay? What you're looking for, this is that zone. We hit the 125.20 area. We break it. We get the 125 area, the M1 pivot point. And what we're looking for is any kind of a clue. And the first clue that you're going to get is a higher low, okay? And that's what you get right here. So what you've got, even though this is a one-minute chart, all right, is you have yourself a higher low right after hitting support. You never want to look at a higher low on a one-minute chart without support. There's no point of that. I mean, the one-minute chart is meant to be used as a scalpel, not as a trade planning tool. You don't want to make your trade plans from such a short-term indicator. It's just chart. It's just not. You're going to get spanked all over the place if you do that. But the idea of taking an entry right around here, okay, at 15 with a stop at a lower low, very sound because of this higher low. And that's actually what I took. Now, this was not the only entry. If you had waited a little longer, okay, this is what like a 382 up until that point at 22. This is right at, if you look at the very bottom here, this 3 a.m. is 8 a.m. London. This is right at London Open. You're getting some green off that 382. And remember, we're targeting at least the 125.70 or 80 zone. But this recent swing high here at 44 was really the closest thing. So some of you may have skipped that one. But if you took the one prior to London, London Open, then there's no reason not to just take the risk off the table, lock and break even at that point, and hands off the wheel. And that's pretty much the best way to handle it. Now, if you didn't take either of those, you saw the wicks here break, that's great. Now you're looking for an entry. If I go back to a 15-minute chart, because this is the 15-minute 21 EMA, okay? So when you're watching this little lower high here on the 1 minute, this is reaction off the 15-minute 21 EMA. In other words, a fib of this swing. So the likelihood is what's going to happen usually in this scenario is this. Okay? And that's what you're looking for, is more of a 15-minute higher low. And as you can see, it looks like a wick, but that's exactly what you got. And this is how it looks like on a one-minute chart. You see the little lower high. And if you've not been around for one of these earlier entries, you're doing a fib of the entire move. And by the way, you could have been taking a short there again. No, there's nothing wrong with that plan. Just the sustainability of that seemed less likely because we had already hit the support that is all over every chart. Scroll over here. Just wait. Whoops, just drawing a little wrong there. And what you're waiting for is any kind of green. Okay, so you could have taken it right here at what's that, 125.25, basically the area that we had previously wanted to break. And at that point, you shoot up to about 50. You can lock in break even. And that's it. How hard was that? Okay. And so essentially, you got yourself, 25, 30 pips in profit within a few minutes. You lock in break even. And what was the risk on that? Okay. If you're wondering where you would have put a stop on that, there's two ways you would have done it. You would have either put a stop under the 786 Fib extension or possibly just underneath this previous swing, 618, at around 19. So you're talking, 10 to 15, maybe 20 pips risk for a target of at least, 50, 60 pips. That's pretty reasonable risk versus reward, and that's what we were dealt with. Now, I'm going to show you how this panned out on a three-minute chart the rest of the day. Let me go to a three-minute chart. All right, this is essentially the higher low on the 1 minute I told you about at first, and this is the 15-minute higher low. We get all the way up to the 125.70 area that I was referring to, and sure enough, on a one-minute chart, we get a lower high, and that was really, the bulk of the move, and it started to fall off of that. Now, this here, though, is not part of the technical move. Now, I'm going to show you the 15-minute chart and just zoom it out to current, all right? This 70 area, as we talked about, was previous resistance, was absolutely, if you look at this, a 4-hour 5 EMA and a central pivot point. Every reason in the world to expect a reaction at that point. So that was where a lot of us took partial profit. But this was some Japanese funding news that came out and skyrocketed this within, I'm talking minutes, up to 126. So that turned this into basically a 100 pip trade, had you hung on to it, or from the 15-minute entry, an 85 pip trade. Because most of us, including myself, scaled part of our trade at the 71 area when we started to get clues of reversal. There was no reason to completely get out until we broke the 21 back to the downside, right? Shoots up from the fundamental news, scalp down, and I'm not going to go into the other entry short, which did indeed exist. But basically, not to beat around the bush here, we were just playing a scalp off of the profit take zone around that M1 pivot point visual support zone on the daily. And now it's just going to be a situation in New York of, are we going to break this or not? If we do, then I think there's a very good chance of 124. If not, then we might consolidate till next week or maybe even start heading up. Because if you go back to this weekly chart, okay, back this out, we are in the midst of a pretty big area of contention here. This goes back years, and this is you could draw this trend line in a couple different ways, but let's just call it right around this, 128, about right around 128 or so. Looks to be like a very big line in the sand, in my opinion, on this area. And if we can break the 128 zone to the upside, we've got a long way to go. And right now we're kind of trapped between that 128 and probably the 124 zone. And that 124 is now the bottom of this daily sort of trap. So this is really going to be an interesting time to see where we go with this pair. Anyway, that was just one of the trades we did today at fxbootcamp.com. There were quite a few. If you'd like to learn how to build these sorts of trade plans on a regular basis, we'd love to have you in class. Please come check us out. Have a fantastic weekend, folks.